Yes, you're welcome. It's your boy Jacob. Now, in this video today, we are going to look at how we can start a nursing school here in Uganda. We have over 50 nursing schools here in Uganda, but they are not enough because nurses work in almost each and every department here in Uganda. They work in theater, they work in ICU, they work on general wards, they open up drug shops, they open up pharmacies. They work in clinics. There's a lot a nurse can do here in Uganda. But in this video today, we are going to see how you can open up a nursing school here in Uganda. So if you're Ugandan and you're in the diaspora or you're here in the country and you think this is one of your entrepreneurship ideas, just stick around until the end of the video because I'm going to give you all the details you need to know if you are really interested in starting up a nursing school here in Uganda. So here I'm going to show you what's needed to start a nursing school here in Uganda and also all the requirements which are needed to start a nursing school, especially an enrolled level nursing school here in Uganda. First of all, you need to get application form from the Ministry of Education and Sports, specifically from the health department in the ministry. Those forms have a checklist of things you need to have in place for you to start a nursing school and for them to come and inspect and give you a license to start a nursing school. So here in this video, I'm going to only give the specifics, those things which you don't have to lack before you call in for inspection or before you start a nursing school. So one of the things is a skills lab. A skills lab is very important, one of the essentials if you are to be given a license to start a nursing school. In a skills lab is where nurses are going to carry out procedures to practice for them to get the skills to start working on the wards. So it contains each and everything. It's like a mini hospital. All the apparatus, beds, monitors, each and everything which is needed for them to acquire the skills to start working. Then another thing is a computer lab. A computer lab is also very necessary before you start up a nursing school. It's one of the major requirements. Then you need a library where all the textbooks which the nursing students are going to use when studying is very important. You need classroom blocks, at least 4 or 5 of them, because for enrollment level there are already 3 sets, first year, second year and third year somewhere. Roughly you need 4 to 5 classroom blocks plus an administration block, of course. Then you need hostels, are also important, especially on enrollment level of studying. Most of them have to come from inside, but for those upper classes, diploma and degree, they can come from outside, but enrollment, they have need to be on the school itself. So that one is very important. Then you need tutors, at least 4 qualified health tutors with a bachelor's degree in tutorship at enrollment level. Yeah, so that's very important. Each tutor is estimated to cater for around 40 students. Roughly 4 qualified tutors would be enough for you to start up a nursing school at enrollment level. Then another thing is hospital for practice. Now this is very important. Your nursing students need where they are going to exercise their skills. So you need to get an attachment to some of the hospitals near a place you are going to set up your nursing school. So you need to get one of the government facilities or missionary facilities or hospitals, and you request them for your students to have an attachment to that hospital. There's always some fee which is paid for them to start practicing from there. So it's a mutual understanding between the school and the hospitals. So that one also has to be, an agreement has to be in this place. Security is also important on your school. Then another thing, land. You need to show ownership of that land where you're going to build a school. You need to show ownership of it.
or if you are renting a certain area, you need to have an agreement of around 4 to 5 years, which shows that they have accepted you to use that place for the school for that period of time. So there are many things which are needed to be in place on that checklist, but these are the major ones which I've mentioned. So after you put each and the minimum requirements needed for you to start a nursing school and they are in place already, you organize for inspection from the Ministry of Education and Sports plus the Nursing Council. They all come as a group to come and inspect your new school. So they come with that checklist, they check in that each and everything, skills lab, library, computer room, they check each and everything and they keep ticking on that checklist. But on inspection, you need to prepare at least 5 million for that. So if each and everything is okay, they'll give you a license to start your nursing school. So next we are going to look at the total estimated cost which is needed, the minimum, the average needed for you to start a nursing school at enrollment level. That is enrolled nursing and enrolled midwifery. So a major thing which is very important is a skills lab. Now in the skills lab, I'm going to give you some of the few things which have to be in the skills lab. A skills lab is more like a mini hospital. All those things which are in a mini hospital, which students need practice on before they go to hospital. Whatever they do in the skills lab is what they are going to do in the hospital. So basically you need medical dummies, which are known as mannequins. Now mannequins are those simulation models which you see in those which students have to practice on, like injection, dressing. They are more in a human form. Let me show you. Some are for anatomical features, if they need to study anatomical features. Others are like for dressing, like delivery. All of them, they are in model form, so they are called mannequins. Now mannequins are expensive. To collect all the necessary one, you might take you around 15 million shillings. Then you need beds, because students need to do bed laying, like nursing students, they need to do postoperative beds, admission beds, cardiac beds, so they need to practice on how to make beds. Then you need hospital trays, all of all types. Nursing students need to know how to prepare different trays for their doctors and for carrying out procedures. You need screens, monitoring equipment, BP machines, thermometers, monitors, kidney dishes, dressing packs, very important. Nurses do a lot of dressings, solutions, alcohol, gauze, cotton, gloves, and all equipment. It's more like a mini hospital where students practice, but from a skills lab. So they practice all the procedures they are going to do before they go to the hospital. So they practice them with their teachers and they are teaching them. So the total cost of a skills lab is estimated to go around 70 million shillings. Now I've inquired from very many nursing tutors and the most of those principal tutors the estimated cost. So these are not just my own, but I've inquired a lot about them, and basically all of them say it's around 70 million shillings for you to make a skills lab in a nursing school, an average one. Then computer lab. Yes, a computer room is very important. Now our computers nowadays are very cheap. You can collect around 15 to 20 computers at around roughly 80 to a million shilling desktops. Nowadays they are not very expensive. You can even get older versions. So for you to create a computer lab, it can take you around 20 million. Then a library with nursing tests and books can take you around 40 million. Some of those nursing books are expensive, like Anatomy, Ross and Wilson, nursing textbooks. Most of them are expensive, go to around 50 to 60,000. So to make a good library for your nursing students, it might take you around 40 million or even more. So this is just an estimated value of an average library. So classroom blocks, hostels and furniture. In the case you are building, those things can take you around 300 million. Yes, that's our estimated cost. But if you are renting out, it's different. You need to rent, of course, those ones you pay monthly. I couldn't estimate because our rent varies from place to place. But I'm taking for someone who is building afresh. So you can estimated cost can take you around 300 million for around 4 to 5 classroom block. So 300 million I've estimated plus the hostels and some furniture. Furniture cannot be so expensive, but more than hostels. So basically that one I've estimated it to be roughly 300 million for classroom blocks, hostels plus furniture for your school. Then school inspection cost, as we talked about it earlier, for your school to be inspected, you need to prepare 5 million as the inspection fee for your nursing school. Then other things which are important: hospital attachment costs, security, staffing, recreation, catering. Those ones I've estimated them to take around 150 million shillings. So in brief, the total cost of starting a nursing school at enrollment level will take you around 585 million to a billion shillings. So this is an estimated cost if you're one of those people who want to start nursing schools in Uganda. There are so many over 50, but they are not enough. You can still start. And there are so many people who want to start nursing schools, but they don't know how. But the demand is still more because nurses work almost everywhere. So they are never enough. Even if the country is producing as many as, they are never enough. So if you're one of those people out there and you really want to start a nursing school here in Uganda, in brief, this is what you need to do if you are to start a nursing school. And this is the estimated cost which you will incur if you are to start a nursing school. It can be slightly higher depending on the levels of nursing you want to train and the area you want to place a nursing school. But roughly, this is an estimated average amount of money which you will need to start a nursing school here in Uganda.